Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Knowledge Unlimited, and in this video I am going to explain about the analysis of first order system. So as I already told you and I have explained and derived the transfer function of the first order system as 1 by 1 plus ST, that is the basic RC network. And we obtained the transfer function by taking output here and input applied at these terminals. So you can go through that video so that this can be considered as continuation further. And in this video I am going to explain each and every term that I had used till now in the series of playlist we have seen till now. So now let me design the system. That is, here let us take input R of s as a unit step input. So its s Laplace transform is 1 by s. This is given as input to the system, a standard first order system, that is 1 by 1 plus st. And here we are going to get the output, that is in s domain C of s. So now here we are going to observe the beauty of Laplace transforms, that is in time domain this is solved using the convolution. The convolution in time domain is simply will become a multiplication in Laplace or S domain. So simply to obtain C of S, it's enough if you multiply the input 1 by S into 1 by 1 plus ST. So now here you can use the technique of or the method of partial fractions to get the output in T domain. That is, you can write it as A by S plus B by 1 plus ST. And if you take LCM and solve here, it is A into 1 plus ST plus B into S by S into 1 plus ST. So now, if you solve these two, to get this, that is numerator is 1 here. So if you take the coefficients of S, that is A into T plus B equal to 0 since there are no S terms, and A equal to 1. So simply you can write A equal to 1 because the coefficient of constant is only A and here the constant is 1. So A equal to 1, if you substitute here B, you will get B as minus T. Now I am going to substitute these two in the equation. So now it will become C of S equal to A value is 1, that is 1 by S minus, I mean here it will be plus, but B equal to minus T. So simply I am writing minus T by 1 plus ST since A equal to 1 and B equal to minus T. We substitute in the previous equation. Now if you take inverse Laplace transforms, C of S will be converted into C of T, which is equal to 1 by S means it is simply a unit step function U of T minus 1 by here you can take T as common. That is, if you take T as common, T and T at T will get cancelled. Let me write here T by T into 1 by T plus S. So T and T get cancelled. It will be 1 by S plus 1 by T. The inverse Laplace transform of 1 by S plus A equal to e power minus AT. So simply you can write here e power minus AT. A is 1 by T here. So 1 by T, T by 1 by T into U of T. So now, had I did any mistake here? Or simply you can, okay, e power minus AT, right? So A, you should multiply 1 by T. It's not division, it's multiplication. So here you can write it as U of T minus e power minus AT, that is 1 by T into T. So that's what I'm thinking. I wrote some mistake, so now I corrected it. So now if you take U of T as common, then it is 1 by e power minus 1 by t into U of T. So this is the response of the system, the first order system for a unit step input. So now from this equation we are going to derive the remaining relations. So you let me write this equation here again. C of t equal to 1 minus e power minus t by t into u of t. So now let me plot this step by step. E power minus t means it is exponentially decaying function. At t equal to 0, e power minus 0 is 1, so it will start with 1 and it will decay exponentially with time. So it is exponential function. So now e power minus t by t in the sense at initially at t equal to 0 it will start with 1, that is no change. At t equal to capital T, for example at t equal to capital T, it is e power minus 1, that is 1 by e. So its value is somewhere at 1 by e, or e power minus 1 you can say. So here at t equal to 2t, its value is e power minus 2, e power minus 2. So in this way you can plot this as again exponentially decaying, but the value will you can get the values here. So now the next term is minus e power minus t by t. So now if you multiply the same with minus 1, if you multiply the same with minus 1, now you will go down directly to negative axis. Since plus 1 is multiplied with minus 1, so you will start your graph with minus 1 and it will go like this. The same values will remain, but it will go in the opposite direction. So now finally you are adding 1 to it, that is the final plot is 1 minus e power minus t by tau into u of t. So this is minus e power t by tau. So if you are adding 1 to it, so minus 1 plus 1, so it will start with 0, it will start with 0 and it will go like this. So this is the ultimate response of the system. So now let me draw this clearly. So the response we have obtained will look something like this. So here this is the response of 1 minus e power minus t by t into u of t. So now let me plot input signal. We have considered the input signal as u of t, which means it is 0 in the negative axis and it will be 1 in the positive axis. Why I am highlighting this is, so this is the input that we have given and this is the response that we are obtained for the first order system. So this is a very important thing that one should notice. Now from this graph we can find the different values at what will be the value at t equal to t and t equal to 2t and so on. So now if you take a deeper look at t equal to t, let me calculate this. So the response value c of t is 1 minus e power minus 1 into u of t. So for time being this value is 1, because at t greater than 0, since it is unit step input, this magnitude will be 1. So 1 minus e inverse equal to 0.632, you can check that in the calculator. And what its value at t equal to 2t? So let me do some there will be some value, let me take it as 4t. So 1 minus e power minus 4, which is equal to 0.98. so now you can see it's almost reached to its saturation state, that is 0.98. so let me perform at t equal to 5t. So at t equal to 5t, its value is 1 minus e power minus 5. So this value is equal to almost 0.99. So you can see we reached the maximum saturation state. And here also you can see at its final value, as I mentioned in my previous video, at the t equal to infinity, you can calculate the steady state, and this is used to find the errors and minimization of error. Here the actual output it should reach is 1, but here we are ending up with 0.99, so there is a error of 0.01, and this is obtained at t equal to infinity. So in this case t equal to 5t can be called as t equal to infinity case or steady state case. So now from these values, keeping in mind, we can derive several relations, that is, what is meant by a time constant of a first order system? The time constant. So the time duration at t equal to t, we obtain its value as 0.632, which is equal to 63.2% of its final value. So if you remember the definitions in that way, how they are constructed, then you can get anything related to that concept that we have discussed. So it can be explained as the time duration in which the response of the system reaches 63.2% of its final value is called as the time constant of the system, and it's purely depends on the components that are used to design the system that we already discussed in the previous video. For omega n and zeta, all we have obtained the relation like this. So all we have discussed, all no need now. If you want, you can go through them. And another definition is the settling time. So this is the time constant definition, and one more definition is settling time, TS. So this can be the duration of the response, the duration at which the response will be up to 2% error to 5% error is allowed, but mostly we will go with a 2% error. So if you recall, at TS equal to 40, we got 0.98, which is a 2% error. So for the first order system, the time period T, settling time at T equal to 40, or the time period 40, is called as the settling time of the system. I am mentioning one more time, these points are only for first order system, and during the analysis of second order system, all might differ. So please, you strictly remember these points only for the first order system. So now, one more definition, with that I am going to conclude this, that is a rise time TR. This have a very peculiar definition, that only for first order system, only first order system. Why I am stressing this point, you please take care of this. This is the time taken for the response, time taken for response to reach 90% of its final value from 10% of its final value. So from 10%, for example, this is only for first order system, we got the response of the system like this. So if here it is my 10% of its final value, and if here it is my 90% of its final value, then the time taken for the system to reach from 10% of its final value to 90% of its final value is called as the rise time of the system. And there is one more thing that I would like to add here, that is, you can calculate a simple and interesting relation. For example, let me take t rise time equal to t2 minus t1. This t2 is at 90% and this t1 is at 10%. So I already plotted, let me do that again. Here it is my 10% and here it is my 90%. So this is my rise time. So here, let me calculate at t equal to t1. The c of t equal to 10%, that is 0.01, if you calculate it. 0.01 is 1%, so it is 0.1. So its final value is 0.1. at t equal to t1, that is 1 minus e power minus t1 by t. So now e power minus t1 by t equal to 1 minus 0.1, that is 0.9. so t1 equal to t times of ln 0.9, and minus will come here. So how I did, you all know, applying logarithms on both sides, you will get ln 0.9 equal to ln e power minus t1 by t. So log e power anything, it will come to front part, that is minus t1 by t into ln e to the base e, that is 1. So if you remind t1 this side, then capital T will go to the right side, so, and minus term will also go to the right side. So it is minus t ln minus 0.9. So at t equal to t2, its c of t is 90%, so it will be 0.9. So similarly, 0.9 equal to 1 minus e power minus t2 by t. So here, if you calculate t2, you will get 1 minus 0.9, so 0.1, it is, here it is, plus 0.1. So now, t raise time equal to t2 minus t1, which is equal to minus t ln 0.1 minus of minus, that is plus t ln 0.9. So if you simplify, you will get approximately 2.2t. So the rise time of the first order system is given by this formula. In the ECA, electronic circuit analysis, you will come with this formula while dealing about hybrid pi model and all those sums. you will be left over with this point, that is t raise time equal to t2 minus t1 of the first order system, that is 2.2t. So with this, we did this analysis for unit step response. So in the similar way, you can carry out for unit impulse. So it all depends on your interest, how much further you want to explore on this concept, and you can do it for unit ramp, unit parabolic, and you can observe the differences, how they differ in their response. Simply, if you want, we know that unit impulse response equal to d by dt of step response. So we all know the step response as 1 minus e power minus 1 by t. So if you, I am only explaining here, so you just take a look at it. Derivative of this, derivative of 1 is 0, derivative of exponential will become this minus into minus 1 by t into e power minus t by t. Minus and minus get cancelled, so you will get 1 by t into e power minus t by t. So this is for impulse response. This for impulse input, the response of the first order system is given by this, that is 1 by t into e power minus t by t. Similarly, you can do for ramp response. So you can plot graph for this. I think you will get exponentially decaying, something like this you will get for this. And you can do for ramp, that is integral. Derivative, if you do derivative first step, then you will get impulse. If you do integral first step response, then you will get ramp response. So in this way, you can do the analysis for different systems. So in that way, you can do the analysis for different systems. So hope you guys enjoyed this video a lot, and that's all for this video, and see you in the next one.